It is the evening of February 23rd, the final of the women's figure skating. While the competition is already in progress, other skaters are backstage preparing for their performances. The women are divided into four groups of six skaters. This division is based on their ranking after the short program. The last group to skate tonight is comprised of the six skaters with the highest scores. The current leader is 21-year-old Sacha Cohen, who won the United States Nationals 1 month earlier. For Sacha, this is her second Olympics. 4 years earlier at the Salt Lake City Games, she narrowly missed winning a medal when she finished fourth. Just 0.03 of a point behind her is the reigning world champion, Irina Slutskaya of Russia. This is her third Olympic Games. She finished fifth at the 1998 Nagano Olympics and won the silver medal behind America's Sarah Hughes at the 2002 Salt Lake City Games. Leading up to these games, there has been much debate as to who the favorite is to win the gold medal. Some have picked Sacha Cohen, others Irina Slutskaya. But the biggest surprise tonight is the woman who is currently in third place, just 0.71 of a point behind Sacha Cohen, 24-year-old Shizuka Arakawa of Japan. She first competed at the 1998 Nagano Games as a 16-year-old.
It was all like a dream for me, having the honor of marching in the opening day parade and representing my country. And then seeing Midori Ito, the silver medalist from the 1992 Albertville Olympics in figure skating, lighting the urn. Even though we do the same sport, she is on a different level. She is like a god to me. It was 13 days later when I finally had the opportunity to compete in the free program. However, being the only female Japanese figure skater in Nagano made it difficult. I had not competed at a stage like the Olympics before, with the whole world watching. I didn't know how I would measure up to the other skaters at the international level. Plus, I couldn't overcome the fascination of just being at the Olympics. The Japanese people were wonderful. Even our emperor was there. After I finished my program, the crowd gave me a standing ovation and showered me with flowers. You would have thought I had won the gold medal instead of finishing 13th.
Arakawa's return to the Olympic arena has taken her 8 years. She failed to make the 2002 Japanese Olympic team and considered retiring from the sport. For the next 2 years, she concentrated on her skating and won the 2004 World Championships. 1 year later, at the 2005 World Championships, Shizuka finished a disappointing 9th. To prepare for the upcoming Torino Olympics, she found a new coach, Nikolai Morozov, who worked with 2002 Olympic gold medalist Alexei Yugudin of Russia. In Japan, most of the attention was on a 15-year-old, Mao Asada, who had defeated Irina Slutskaya in the 2005 Grand Prix final. However, Olympic rules state that a competitor must be 16 years old to compete at the Olympics. Asada wouldn't be 16 until 9 months after the Torino Games.
Definitely, they've been all crazy about Mao Asada, and they didn't think about Shizuka when it was the beginning of the season. When I talked to the lady from Free Federation, and she asked me, so how is, what's going on? And I said, it's going like well, I said, but you guys need to pay attention more to her because you know that the only one skater who can compete with Sacha Cohen and Slutskaya because she has a spins, she has a beautiful spirals, she has lots of emotions when she is ready to skate perfect, and she has all the jumps.
At the Japanese Nationals, Shizuka finished third and qualified for the Japanese team.
I was trying out different programs to see how many points I could get. I wasn't concerned about winning the nationals, just making the Olympic team. Once I made the team, I could now refine my program with difficult moves that would score points.
Now here in Torino, the final group of skaters begin their 6-minute warm-up. Sacha Cohen will be the second skater to perform. Shizuka will follow her. and the final skater of the evening will be Irina Slutskaya. She is in an enviable position. By skating last, she will know the score she will have to beat. For Nikolai Morozov, there is a connection between the top three skaters. He has worked as a choreographer for Sacha Cohen, and his first coach, Zhanna Gromova, is coaching Irina Slutskaya.
I was very happy that she's in the third place, because being in the first position would be very hard for her or for any of them, because it's so much pressure, you're already first. The first place can only lose or stay first. It's always easy to try to win than try to hold that.
With only 2 days remaining in the Olympics, Japan has yet to medal in any sport. Japan's hopes rest solely on Shizuka Arakawa's performance tonight.
All the Japanese athletes had tried their best. That's all that anyone can ask for. I didn't feel as if I had to get a medal. Pressure is not something to be placed upon you by others. You place it on yourself. The important thing for me is to do my very best and not to worry about winning a medal.
Sacha Cohen will skate to the music from the 1968 film Romeo and Juliet. Sacha will begin her program with a three-jump combination. She loses points because she cannot complete the sequence. She sets up for a triple flip.
I didn't want to know how the other skaters were doing by the reactions of the crowd, so I put my headphones on. People were very tense. It showed they wanted to win, to get the gold medal. All I wanted to do was to be proud of my performance and skate purely for the enjoyment of it.
In Torino, a new scoring system has been implemented. The panel of judges has been increased from 9 to 12. However, only 9 of the scores, selected at random, will count. The judges will grade each element of the program on its difficulty. By adding more elements, a skater increases a routine's point value. But after the halfway point in the routine, the point values are doubled.
I think new system pushing skaters to do much more. And we see this lots of more falls because skaters pushed more to do more difficult spins, more difficult footworks. They have less time to rest. They make much more harder physical work than they've done it before.
Sacha completes her program without any other mistakes. Shizuka Arakawa begins her warm-up.
Sacha Cohen of the United States has a combined total of 183.36 points and is currently in first place.
She will skate to the music of Puccini's Turandot.
I chose this music because I wanted a song that would allow me to concentrate on the skating, but at the same time, convey to the audience the freshness of losing oneself in the joy of skating.
She's very classy, very classy. She looked like a Japanese princess, I would say. she skates always with lots of just heart. And when she's on, nobody can do better than her.
Past the midpoint, she readies for a triple-double-double, which will earn her double points. As Shizuka is nearing the end of her program, Irina Slutskaya is backstage getting ready. Although Shizuka has skated cleanly, she has been conservative, changing some of her triples into doubles. She has left the door open for Slutskaya.
Her technical score is 62.32 points. Program component scores, please. 63.00 points. And is currently in first place.
Now it is time for the last skater of the evening, reigning world champion Irina Slutskaya of Russia. She will skate to a flamenco medley.
I had really no desire to pay attention to anyone else's performance. I had finished my skating and I was surprised that I was able to do my best. I watched Irina's performance, but I was in a daze.
Slutskaya's appearance here is a tribute to her determination. In 2003, she was diagnosed with vasculitis, a disease that caused constant pain and swelling in her limbs. Doctors advised her to take a year off from skating, but within a few months, she was back training. She returned to competition at the 2004 World Championships and finished ninth. The next year, she won the World Championships.
I watched actually together with Shizuka. We've been sitting watching how Slutskaya was skating. Seeing right away when she stepped on the ice, what she was nervous.
Thank you. She has a combined total of 181.44 points and finishes in third place.
The final placings, Shizuka Arakawa first, Sacha Cohen second, and Irina Slutskaya third.
My greatest surprise was that I had won the gold medal. And I didn't realize at the time that this was the first Olympic gold medal won by a figure skater from Japan.
Later that evening at the awards ceremony, Shizuka Arakawa receives the gold medal. Sacha Cohen receives the silver medal, and Irina Slutskaya the bronze.
I had a hard time because coach of Slutskaya was my first coach. When I was like 5 years old, was teaching me how to skate, so I was very sad for her, but also was very happy for Shizuka, what she did.
For the first time at the Torino Olympics, the Japanese national anthem is played. Shizuka's gold medal is the only medal Japan will win at these Olympics. Shizuka Arakawa, an athlete from whom little was expected, but in the end, she lifted the spirit of an entire nation. She epitomizes the belief, if you can bring honor to yourself, you will bring honor to us all.
Mais son